Western Area Peninsula on the west coast of Sierra Leone is part of the Upper Guinean Forest ecosystem. This area is home to an estimated 1.5 million people. That's about 20% of the country's population. The Western Area National Park is at the center of this peninsula. This national park still holds one of the last strongholds of pristine forest in Sierra Leone and represents a significant chunk of the remaining forest cover in the Guinean forest of West Africa hotspot.
What remains is very small, and even the small one that remains is under severe threat. But it's a forest that has valuable plant species. It's a forest that helps to regulate the local microclimate. It's a forest that provides a home for some of the few endangered animal species that we have left.
Rich in diverse species and with a range of hills and steep mountains bordering the coastline, the national park is a unique place on earth to observe wildlife. It has been identified by the Critical Ecosystem Partnership Fund as one of the four key biodiversity areas in Sierra Leone for their investment in the Guinean forests of West Africa hotspot. This nature reserve covers 17 square kilometers of land with about 60% of the forest vegetation still intact. But that's changing. Development is posing a major threat to the future of these vital habitats and species.
Housing developments within the protected areas is a very huge challenge for us right now, because especially when it comes to the Western Area Peninsula National Park, it's very close to the city and everybody wants to stay in the city.
Apart from the 1.5 million people who benefit from the ecosystem services that the park has to offer, there are many plants and animal species, especially birds, that depend on this forest for survival. Located just outside the capital, Freetown, this paradise of biodiversity is now exposed to many threats that are growing in intensity.
The Western Area Peninsula Forest Reserve has a unique challenge in the sense that it's in the middle of a city which is growing rapidly in terms of population size, and therefore people resort to it for livelihood, for accommodation, for land. And there is no proper land use plan.
People have encroached the protected forest for arable land, and farmers have cleared patches of secondary bush in the periphery. Deforestation and stone mining activities, often carried out illegally, are also threatening the ecosystem services from this rainforest. Freetown is a city on the rise, but as usual, growth comes at a cost. As this capital city expands outwards, the rainforests that surround it are slowly but definitely being lost to development. It is a typical conflict, the need to build houses versus the need to protect nature from unsustainable development. Pressure on land has caused people to build on shallow and easily eroded hillsides.
The hills are very steep, and so whenever you have these kind of flash floods, you know, then you have a lot of water settling which cannot be sucked down because it's also a rock area, and you have a saturation which we think may have resulted to the mass movement of this swell after we had those very heavy downpour of rains.
As the city pushes up into the mountains of the forested national park, pressure from the population is damaging the forest. Trees have been cut down by people who want land for housing, and those who cut for firewood. The trees prevent runoff, and the forest holds water. But cutting has increased the risk of mudslides. Calls to stop the extension of settlements into the peninsula's hills and properly manage development have been largely ignored. In August 2017, a hillside collapsed, causing a mudslide on the outskirts of Freetown. Mudslides are rare in Sierra Leone, but conservation experts say this was not surprising.
We saw this coming, we talked about it. There have been conferences, there have been workshops, there have been all kinds. There was even a project, conservation of the Western Area Peninsula Forest and its watersheds, which was supposed to demarcate the boundary of the forest and identify the watersheds, create awareness about their protection and all of that. That project ended. We were supposed to have a clear indication that there is this boundary, but that was not respected.
The landslide occurred in the mountain town of Regen after 3 days of torrential rain. Regen is only 16 kilometers away from Freetown and sits between the Atlantic Ocean and a range of hills. Many people in Regen live in informal settlements on hillsides. Local communities residing near the Western Area National Park were seriously affected by the disaster.
On August 14th, when I saw where the 3 minute car, everyone around there 6 o'clock, in the first 7 o'clock. Then the rain began to come, where the disaster took place. Then I said, the rain began heavy. So myself now, I've been on fire again because the dew all cover. And I see nobody, but I see this area, so it don't crack. So myself now, all my people, all my friends there, all my way they don't, my family there, all watch, I see the hill, it just come up on them. But not so all man, they be able for pull, na matome community.
Most lights overran several houses and killed hundreds of residents, many of whom were trapped inside their homes.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way.
The mudslide and rain overwhelmed Freetown's drainage system and created waterways that brought down steep streets in the city.
I'm actually a PhD student from the Netherlands, and I'm coming here to do research about natural disasters, and especially the response to natural disasters. It's part of a larger research project, and it looks at the response to natural disasters in different governance settings. And there are different case studies. Sierra Leone mudslide here is one of them. And what we try to do is actually look at the different responders, state responders, aid responders, INGOs, NGOs, but especially also community initiatives.
The forests of the Western Area National Park are vital, life-giving ecosystems, and their destruction is a situation that should concern not only local conservation groups, but everyone who lives in or near the capital of this West African country. To save the forest, encroachment needs to be stopped, or at least slowed.
As small grants program in a country, we have supported quite a number of CSOs who have been able to do extremely well within the Western Area Forest Reserve. And some of them have actually provided livelihood options to communities that actually depend on the Western Area Forest for their livelihood. But what I would say is that the key problem is coordination amongst the CSOs generally working in the environment sector.
Local conservation organizations on the ground, like the Conservation Society of Sierra Leone and the Environmental Foundation for Africa, are working to preserve this paradise of biodiversity, but are confronted by several challenges.
We have done a lot of advocacy working with the government and the people to make sure that we avoid those places, because it's also a catchment area where the whole city relies for water supply. And we keep on shifting even the boundaries. We have done boundary demarcations, and there are encroachments coming, and we have to re-demarcate. And we try to work with people to see reason not to cut the forest.
The mudslide has reminded stakeholders of the need to create and maintain effective frameworks for environmental protection.
The first thing to do would be to take a really serious look at where we are currently, where the Western Area Peninsula Forest is, how permits are being given, where people are being allowed to build. Maybe stop, impose a moratorium on any future constructions, especially on the hillsides. Take a closer look at how to relocate some of those people that are in areas that could potentially also collapse. And then, of course, there is now a need to look at how we can mainstream biodiversity conservation in the planning and execution of all manner of programs.
Threats to the Western Area National Park are many and growing, but local conservationists are looking forward to emerging opportunities that support a multi-stakeholder approach in their efforts to identify and implement long-lasting solutions.
And at the moment, even we are planning to have a national conference on the Western Area Peninsula alone. We now, through a planning grant from CEPF, we are trying to bring together some of those actors so that we can act together to have a united front in addressing these challenges that we are facing, and to really kind of stop a recurrence of this kind of disaster that we experienced.
Civil society organizations in Sierra Leone have committed to save the Western Area National Park and protect the countless benefits that this forest provides to the local communities.